In this video, we're continuing on with the radical equations worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section. And this is radical equations part 2, otherwise known as radical equations hard. Now, for number 8, we're going to start by squaring both sides. And doing this, we'll get 5v equal to v squared, because the square root of 5v squared is 5v. Now, I'll subtract v squared from both sides. So we'll have 5v minus v squared equal to 0. So I can pull out a v from each of these terms. So we'll have v times 5 minus v equal to 0. So I need to see when v equals 0 and when 5 minus v equals 0. So v equals 0 will make this equation equal to 0. And when v is equal to a positive 5, this equation will also be equal to 0, because 5 minus 5 equals 0, and 0 times any quantity is 0. So I have two solutions in number 8, 0 and 5. And I'll write those in set notation. And number 9, I'll square both sides again at the start. So I'll have r squared equal to 10r. So I'll subtract 10r from both sides in order to get one side equal to 0. 10r minus 10r is 0. So I'll have r squared minus 10r equal to 0. And there's an r in each of these terms, so I'll factor that. Pulling out that r, I'll get r times r minus 10 equal to 0. So I need to see when r equals 0 and when r minus 10 equals 0. And this is true when r equals 0, r is 0, 0 times any quantity is 0, and r minus 10, that will equal 0 when r is equal to a positive 10, because 10 minus 10 is 0. So I have two solutions for number 9, 0 and 10. R equals 0 and r equals 10. And number 10, starting by squaring both sides, I'll get that m squared is equal to 56 minus m. So I'll add m to both sides in order to cancel out that m on the right. And I'll also subtract 56 from both sides in order to cancel out that 56. So I'll have m squared plus m minus 56 on the left-hand side of my equation, and that's equal to 0. So I'm going to be factoring this quadratic. And in order to do that, I need to see what two terms multiply to give me a negative 56 and add to give me a positive 1. So the factors of 56 that will work are 7 and 8. However, that's going to work when 7 is negative, because negative 7 plus 8 is a positive 1, and negative 7 times 8 is a negative 56. So we'll have m minus 7 times m plus 8 as m squared plus m minus 56 factored, and that's going to be equal to 0. So we're going to solve for when m minus 7 equals 0, and we're going to be solving for when m plus 8 equals 0. For m minus 7 equal to 0, that's going to be true when m equals 7, because 7 minus 7 is 0. And for m plus 8 equals 0, that's going to be true when m equals a negative 8, because negative 8 plus 8 equals 0. And remember, 0 times any quantity is 0. So this equation is true when m equals 7 and when m equals negative 8. However, we need to see if both of those will make the original equation true. Remember, the original equation was m equals the square root of 56 minus m. When we take the square root of a quantity, we will never get a negative number. Therefore, m cannot equal a negative number, so m cannot be negative 8. So even though there's two solutions that made this equation true, there's only one solution that will make this equation true, that original equation. And that's when m is equal to 7. So 7 is our solution in number 10. And we didn't have to worry about that for number 8 or 9 because we never had a negative value for our variable. Let's move on to number 11. In number 11, when I start by squaring both sides, I'll get that b squared is equal to negative 4 plus 4b. So I'll be adding a positive 4 to both sides, and at the same time, I'll subtract 4b from both sides. So I'll have b squared minus 4b plus 4 equal to 0. So now I'll factor that quadratic. I need to see what two numbers multiply to give me positive 4 and add to give me. So the factors of 4 are 2 and 2. Negative 2 times negative 2 equals a positive 4, and negative 2 plus negative 2 equals a negative 4. So we'll have b minus 2 times b minus 2 equal to 0. However, b minus 2 times b minus 2 we can simplify as b minus 2 squared. That's equal to 0. So we're going to see when b minus 2 equals 0. And that's true when b is equal to a positive 2. So our only solution in number 11 is 2. So when b is 2, 2 minus 2 is 0, 0 squared is equal to 0, and plugging 2 into this original equation will hold true. Because negative 4 plus 4 times 2 is negative 4 plus 8, which is a positive 4, and the square root of 4 is a positive 2. And number 12, squaring both sides in order to get rid of that radical, we'll get r squared equal to 8r. So I'll subtract 8r from both sides to get that r squared minus 8r equals 0. Now I'll be able to pull out an r from each of those terms. So I'll have r times r minus 8 equal to 0. So this equation is true when r equals 0 and when r minus 8 equals 0. So one solution for r is that it's equal to 0, and the other solution is that r is equal to a positive 8, because 8 minus 8 equals 0, 0 times any quantity is 0. So in number 12, I have two solutions, 0 and 8. Moving on to number 13, I'm going to start by squaring both sides. So I'll get negative 16 plus 10a equal to a squared. So I'll subtract a squared from both sides in order to get that negative a squared plus 10a minus 16, just switching the negative 16 and the 10a, that's going to equal 0. I don't want my a squared to be negative, so I'm going to multiply both sides by negative 1. Negative 1 times negative a squared is positive a squared, plus negative 1 times 10a is negative 10a, so I'll subtract a positive 10a, and then negative 1 times negative 16 is going to be positive 16. Because negative 1 times 16 is negative 16, and if we're subtracting a negative, that's the same as adding a positive. And then 0 times negative 1 is 0. So I'm going to be factoring a squared minus 10a plus 16. So what two numbers multiply to give me a positive 16 and add to give me a negative 10? That's going to be 2 and 8. Negative 2 and negative 8 more precisely. Because negative 2 times negative 8 equals positive 16, and negative 2 plus negative 8 is a negative 10. So we'll have a minus 2 times a minus 8. That's equal to 0. So I'm going to see when a minus 2 equals 0 and when a minus 8 equals 0. A minus 2 equals 0 when a is equal to a positive 2, and a minus 8 equals 0 when a is equal to a positive 8. So you can see that both of my solutions are positive, therefore they will remain true for that original equation. So I'll have 2 and 8 as my solutions in number 13. Now let's go over number 14. I'll square both sides to get that r squared equals negative 1 minus 2r. So I'll add 1 to both sides, and I'll also add 2r to both sides. So on my left-hand side, I'll have r squared plus 2r plus 1, and that's equal to 0. Now I need to see what two numbers multiply to give me 1 and add to give me positive 2. My factors of 1 are 1 and 1. So 1 times 1 multiplies to give me 1, and 1 plus 1 adds to give me 2. So I'll have r plus 1 times r plus 1. That's equal to 0. R plus 1 and r plus 1 I can write as r plus 1 squared. So r plus 1 squared equals 0. So when r plus 1 equals 0, then this equation will be 0. So r plus 1 equals 0, subtracting 1 from both sides, when r is equal to negative 1. Negative 1 plus 1 equals 0. So negative 1 is my solution for this equation. However, looking back at our original equation, we had r equal to the square root of negative 1 minus 2r. And we know that r cannot be negative because we're taking the square root of some quantity and that will not give us a negative answer. So minus 1 is not a solution. Therefore, for number 14, there are no solutions. And again, that's because after we factored and solved, we got that r was equal to a negative 1, but r cannot be a negative number. So again, there are no solutions in number 14. And I'll go ahead and stop this video here. Join me in the next video where I'll continue on to the second page of this worksheet. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below, or if you just want to leave me a note, put that in the comments below as well. And while you're doing that, don't forget to click that like button and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated, and just let me know that you're finding these videos useful. So go ahead and do that before continuing on.